What's up guys, GG Racing here, and today I'm going to show you how to get faster across the track, this time by focusing on the throttle pedal. I'm going to show you here the top 3 common mistakes that make you lose time, how to fix them, and more importantly you'll understand in simple terms what a perfect lap should look like when we check throttle telemetry. I've ordered the following principles based on how much it could affect your time across the lap, so if you had to pick just a single thing from all these tips, here's the number 1 mistake you'll want to fix. Let's start! Mistake number 1 is doing multiple throttle corrections while taking a corner. This is how it looks like if we draw it. What we want is a linear progression of throttle application as shown on the left graph. A big red flag is something that you see on the right. There we have multiple throttle corrections throughout the whole corner. That's usually a bad thing. Let's observe it in game in order to understand it better. As you can see, initially we go on the throttle, then we notice we have a wide exit, we lower our throttle input, then we push it again, but one more time we have to lower the throttle application. After these types of corrections, we end up losing plenty of time. Going back to some actual telemetry, you'll see here side by side a corner of one good lap versus the same corner but from the bad lap. These type of patterns should ring a bell when you see these throttle corrections. More often than not, you're doing something wrong, so just keep it in mind. The second mistake is car specific, but it shows an important principle. It's not okay to go from 0 to 100% throttle too fast. On powerful cars, this will make you lose rear grip and spin, and even if you drive GT cars that have traction control assist, you'll have a slower exit if you trigger the TC. So even though you're not spinning, you're actually losing time. There could be some exception to this, such as low HP front wheel drives, but as a rule of thumb, you'll want to make a good habit and avoid this throttle mistake. As we did before, this is how it looks like if we draw it. We want a progressive input as seen on the left side, not too steep as it is on the right side. Let's see some examples in game.
Mă, frate, cum să...
Wow. Are you okay?
To fix this, you need to modulate the pressure applied on the throttle. Different things can help here, as adding a small dead zone in the game settings, avoiding being aggressive on cold tires, or getting a premium set of pedals with a dampener. Whatever works for you. Third, and the final mistake that I'd like to point your attention is overlapping brake and throttle. It's not as big as the other two, but the downside is that you'll have more tire wear and, in some cases, it could unsettle the car. This is how this pattern looks like if we draw it. It usually happens in double apex corners, where we try to trail brake for the whole duration and adjust with our throttle. In the end, these three are in my opinion the most common beginner mistakes on this subject. It's super simple to understand and visualize these tips, and from here we can build up with more specific and subtle things. I consider it a starting point or an example for you to understand basic telemetry, so you can use these principles, analyze your own laps, and see if the throttle is costing you time. That was it from my side, thanks for sticking around. If you find it useful, I wanted to let you know that I plan to do a similar video in the future, focusing on more telemetry patterns, so if you like things like this, then subscribe the channel. See you on the next one. Bye.